up, everybody? This is Kunai, and today I'm going to be talking about five businesses that you can do if you are living in Zimbabwe as a young person. So let's get right into it. Number one, there's buying and selling. Yes, buying and selling. You can do buying and selling and you can make a lot of money in Zimbabwe. If you check most of the people who are in Zimbabwe right now who are making a lot of money, they are doing buying and selling. They are selling stuff. They are going to South Africa. They are going to Zambia. They are going to many different places, many different countries, Tanzania, Dubai, and China. They are going there. Some are going even to Turkey. They are going there. They are buying stuff. They are buying fashion stuff, cosmetics. They are buying like basically everything. If you check nowadays in Zimbabwe, there's less in industries, less manufacturing that is going on in Zimbabwe. So nowadays, everything that is needed in Zimbabwe, everything that is used on a day-to-day life nowadays, is basically coming from somewhere else. So as a young Zimbabwean person, what you can do is you can do buying and selling. You can buy stuff from out of the country, or you can actually buy those things from here in Zimbabwe, like here in Harare. You can find them somewhere else, and then you buy those things and then you sell them at a profit. So this is idea number one. What you can also doing by buying and selling, like nowadays some people can say, I do not have capital to do that. That's not a problem. What you can do is you can sell the stuff that you no longer need in your house. We've got bidding wars. We've got bidding groups in Zimbabwe. For example, there's bidding wars. What you can do is you go on Facebook and then on the search bar you search bidding wars Zimbabwe. You can see bidding groups in Zimbabwe, and you can sell second-hand things that you have in your house to grow, to build your own capital or money that you can use so that you'll be able to buy stuff and then you sell them. So this is idea number one. Idea number two, what you can do, you can sell things on a commission or for a commission. You can buy, no, you don't buy, you can sell other people's products or services for a commission. You can do that and you can make a lot of money. These are some of the things that I personally do. If you check some of the videos that I did previously, there was a time I talked about how I made $300 in around 3 hours. $300 in around 3 hours. What I did was I sold someone else's car and then I made a commission of around $300. So you can do these things. You can go to people who've got car sales. You can go to people who've got things that they are buying, things that they are selling, and then you go there, you negotiate a commission, and when you negotiate the commission, you'll be able to sell that product or service and you get commissions. I'll give you an example. Let's say you are getting $50 for a commission. Let's say you're getting $50 as commission. You just need 10 people. You just need to sell 10 items and then you get $500. You just need to sell 20 items and you'll be able to get $1,000 every single month. So this is something that you can do, and this is something that can bring you a lot of money. Then idea number three, you can provide a service. You see, the beauty of providing a service is that you will not need to go and buy some stuff like co-order. You don't need to do that. You don't need capital when you're doing those things. You don't need capital to provide a service. All you need is to just provide the service. So what you do is you've got a skill that you're good at. You've got something that you're good at, something that you know you can do. You've got a skill. You've got quite a number of things that you can do. There are many people who are willing to give you money to provide a service for the things that you're good at, you yourself are good at. So these are some of the things that you can do. Make sure that you look at the things that you can do and then you provide them as a service. So there are many people who are doing that. If you are good at graphic designing, if you are good at video editing, if you are good at planning events, if you are good at quite a number of things. Let's say you are good at voiceover. You can do that and you can be paid to do that. So then number four, this is social media marketing. What you can do, yes, this one is a service, of course, but I decided to talk about it on its own. I decided to separate it from other ones because this one is something that you can do. We've got people who are making a lot of money who are doing social media marketing. What is happening nowadays is that many companies, many people, many individuals, they are looking for ways to be on social media. Some of them, they are not good at doing social media. Some of them actually do not have the time to be on social media every time. So what they do is they outsource, they look for people who can manage their social media. So this is where you can come in and you can make a lot of money doing that. There are people who are making 5 figures a month, 6 figures a year. Some have even become millionaires. If you check on YouTube, on Google, you can see that there are people who are actually making money doing social media marketing. So get yourself to learn about social media. If you do not yet know what social media can do for you, you can join my group. There's a group that I have. It's called Wired for Success. I'm going to leave a link down below so you'll be able to join the group, or you can inbox me on Facebook so that I will add you in the group, and you will be able to see some of the things that you'll be talking about, as well as learning about social media marketing. Then the last one, which is what I'm doing now, is you can be a YouTuber like me. I am a YouTuber. What I'm doing is I'm putting out content about the things that I prefer doing, the things that I love, the things that I'm passionate about. For example, as for you, like as for me, I talk about social media, I talk about entrepreneurship, I talk about motivation. These are the things that I do. So as for you, the things that you're passionate about, the things that you think you can say, these are my hobbies. These things can be things that you can talk about on YouTube, and you'll be able to grow a brand and grow a business on YouTube. So this is the fifth one. You can be a YouTuber. Many people are turning to YouTube nowadays to express their views concerning different topics, and these things are the things that you can make money doing. If you're in Zimbabwe, I think you know people like Madam Boss, you know people like Ruby Lynn, you know people like the comic Pastor Prosper, you know people like Taffy the Man. These are people who are doing YouTube. Including Japraise as well, he's also doing YouTube. He has got his own YouTube channel, and he's doing video, he's creating content, he's actually making money doing that. So these are some things that you can do. So if you check, Japraise is doing YouTube, but he's doing music. If you check, Madam Boss is doing comedy. If you check, Taffy the Man is doing quite a number of things, including comedy as well and music as well. You can look at Ruby Lynn. I remember when I first saw her, she was doing cosmetics, makeup, and all those things. So these are some of the things that you can do. If you love cooking, if you love swimming, if you love all those things, if you love traveling, you can build an audience around that area that you love. So there you have it. Number one, buying and selling. Number two, sell stuff on commission, provide a service, social media marketing, and you can become a YouTuber. These are not the only businesses that you can do, but these are the businesses that you can do if you are living in Zimbabwe. So thank you so much for joining me in this video. Don't forget to subscribe to this channel, and let us connect and share. Thank you.